ladies, welcome to my channel. My name is Heather Anderson of So Heather, and today I'm excited to share a video about 10 ways to look slimmer in your clothes. This is probably one of the most requested topics that I get, so I can't wait to show you guys how to look slimmer in your everyday looks. I'm also going to be sharing outfits to go along with each of these tips so that you can easily see how to implement them into your everyday lives. Before I get started though, I would hope that you would subscribe to my channel by clicking that little subscribe button. I do publish 2 new videos every single week, and I started my channel to help women over 40, but really women of all ages who still want to look and feel like the best versions of themselves, no matter what your age, because I believe that style knows no age, and that if you look good and feel good, you will exude confidence, and confidence will get you anywhere you want to go. Please listen to this entire video because tip number 10 is actually my favorite tip. It's one that I swear by. It's one that I give a lot of my clients. I was a stylist for a while before I became an influencer. This is something I always tell my clients, always tell my readers, and I always tell you guys because it is definitely my absolute favorite tip. So make sure you listen to all 10 tips before turning off this video. I will be sharing the looks like I told you guys, and if anything is on the expensive side, I will always be linking a steel version down below as well, because I believe no matter what your budget, you should be able to shop on my channel. Okay, tip number 1 in order to look slimmer in your clothes is to go monochrome. And not only will a monochrome look make you look slimmer, but it will also make you look taller. And anything that makes you look taller actually makes you look slimmer. So I think there is nothing more chic than a monochrome look. For those of you that don't know what monochrome means, that basically means wearing the same shade from head to toe. So the first look I want to talk about, I've actually featured this amazing dress on my channel before, but I thought it was worth mentioning again because it is that good. It is under $100. It's from Express, and it's this beautiful camel midi dress. It's a turtleneck fitted midi dress. Again, it's under $100, so it's a really good price. It's also extremely comfortable. It hits right below the knee, hence a midi dress. And I personally think a midi dress is the most flattering for all ages because I feel like our knees are one of the most aging spots on any woman's body. At least they are mine. So that's why I always love a good midi dress. I of course have on Spanx with this outfit, which is another little bonus tip that will also help you look slimmer. I will link my absolute favorite pair of Spanx down below that I swear by. They will actually make you look, I think, at least 10 pounds slimmer. So these are phenomenal. I just topped it with this beautiful faux leather, neutral colored trench coat by Alice and Olivia. I adore this trench coat. I think a trench coat is a staple, a wardrobe classic piece that, you know, will make you look sophisticated. It will make you look chic, and it is just a timeless basic that will never go out of style. So absolutely love this trench by Alice and Olivia. In order to keep the monochrome look, I could have done a nude heel, which would have been amazing, but I decided to take the camel tone and turn it maybe a little bit lighter, and I did an ivory mule. These are by Bottega Veneta, so they are a bit on the pricey side. So I will be linking a steel version down below on the Shopbop website. They literally look almost identical, but they're a fraction of the price. Okay, tip number 2 in order to look slimmer in your clothes is to choose solids over prints. Now, if you've been watching my videos for a while or perusing my blog, you know that 95% of the time I wear solids. And this is really why, because I feel like I just look slimmer when I wear solid colors. Prints, especially big, loud prints, will just make you look bigger than you really are. If you are, you know, somebody that loves wearing prints, that's okay. You can certainly still wear prints, but I would say only wear prints on the top portion of your body. Definitely don't wear like loud, big prints on the bottom portion of your body, because this will definitely make you look bigger than you really are. And if you are going to do a print, I would say stick to an animal print, like a zebra, a leopard print, even camo, I think is okay, but I would stay away from just like the very loud, crazy bright prints. Now, the look I want to talk about showcasing this tip is this really amazing denim on denim look I just shot for White House Black Market. A really cool thing about this look is that it is very affordable. The jacket, this denim peplum jacket, is very flattering because it is a neutral tone and it is also under $100. So what a great deal. I love just leaving it unzipped. And then I just paired a simple white cami underneath this look. Again, another solid. And then I just did these amazing under $100 jeans from White House Black Market. They are very comfortable. They're very slimming. They're an ankle length with a high waist. So I absolutely love them. They're definitely considered a skinny jean, and no, skinny jeans are not out of style in 2021, definitely. But if you are wondering which jeans are really in style for 2021, I just did a video on the top denim this year, so definitely check that out. I will be linking it down below in my description box. And then I just did some pointy toe leopard pumps. These are amazing. I think a pointy toe pump is also another way to elongate your legs, making you look taller and slimmer. All right, tip number three is to not only stick to solids, but to stick to neutral colored solids, because neutrals, meaning like beiges, ivories, light tans, camels, even I feel like even black is considered a neutral color. These colors will make you look slimmer because they are just, you know, obviously neutral tones. They're not going to take away from your silhouette. They're not going to make your silhouette look bigger than it really is because they're just very soft, neutral tones. So that's also why I definitely not only wear solids a lot, but I also wear neutral tones a lot, and this is why. So the look I want to talk about with this tip is this really cool under $100 faux leather white jacket. I found this on the Nordstrom website. And the second I saw it, I fell in love with it. I think a white faux leather jacket is a definite must-have for spring and summer. I know I wear mine a ton during these months, but you can really wear it all year round. What I did is I paired it over an all black look. I did a simple black bodysuit. Then I did these black redone jeans. These are a high-waisted denim with a little bit longer than an ankle length. I am 5'4" for reference. So if you're taller than 5'4", they will hit you a little bit, you know, above the ankle, which I think is also a very flattering length to wear your denim. These are definitely considered a modern skinny. These are more of a slim, straight cut, which I love. I love these jeans so much that I got them in the light wash as well. And I think they're going to be shown later on in this video, so stay tuned. And then again, I just did the same leopard pumps. I feel like a leopard pump will take you so many places in style because a leopard is really considered another neutral print. Even though it is a print, I still feel like it is a neutral print because leopard is very sophisticated. It's very chic. It will never go out of style. So if you don't already have a pair of leopard pumps, I highly recommend adding some to your shoe collection. These are actually by Christian Louis Vuitton, but I found some on the Nordstrom website by Sam Edelman. They're still that calf here leopard print. They're still really cool, really chic, but they're a fraction of the price. Tip number four, in order to look slimmer in your clothes, is to choose a nude pump. So this trick works like a charm. The reason is a nude pump is going to blend in with your skin tone, meaning it will elongate your legs. It's not going to cut your legs off like if you were to wear a black shoe or a colored shoe. Not saying it's wrong to wear a black shoe or a colored shoe, but if you want to look taller, if you want to look slimmer, a nude pump is your best friend. I also think a nude pump is a classic wardrobe staple that every woman needs in her closet. My nude pumps are by Christian Louis Vuitton. I've had them for probably 2 years. I've worn them so much that I actually had to take them to Dino's to have them restored. That's another little tip I shared on one of my videos last week that I did. I think it was like 10 game-changing style hacks. So I will also be linking that video down below. But I love these nude pumps. Sam Edelman also makes a very amazing budget-friendly nude pump as well, which I will be linking down below. But the look I want to talk about with the nude pump tip is this really cool cardigan set. I just got this in from ALC. I love this ivory shade. Again, it's a solid and it is a neutral. Cardigan sets are having a big moment in 2021. They're one of 2021's hottest trends, and I'll have to say one of my favorite trends. So if you're wondering what some other trends are in 2021, I will also link that video down below. But this cardigan set is comfortable. The little tank that's underneath it, you won't show any skin as long as you pair it with a pair of high-waisted denim. So that is exactly what I did. These are the redone jeans I had on earlier, but in the light wash. The silhouette is a high waist with an ankle length. So love this light wash pair of denim by Redone. I will be wearing these jeans all year round because they are that versatile and that wearable. Okay, tip number five in order to look slimmer in your clothes is to always tuck in your shirt. This doesn't mean you have to completely tuck it in, although that is what I typically do. Even if you just do the half tuck and blouse it out a little bit, if you're somebody that does have a little bit of a stomach, that's okay. What I recommend for those types of bodies is to just do the half tuck, blouse the shirt out a little bit over your stomach so you're creating a waistline. So that's definitely a tip. I think it's no matter what size you are, you're going to look slimmer if you tuck in your shirt, again, even if it's just the front portion of your shirt and blouse it out. Okay, tip number six is to add a belt. So if you're gonna tuck in your shirt, you might as well add a belt. Not only is a belt going to elevate your look, take it to the next level, add a bit of interest to your look, but again, it's also gonna make you look slimmer because it's gonna really define your waist. So I just got this ivory belt by Clinch Belts. It's really cool. The reason is you can have the same belt buckle, but then you can order different belts for the same belt buckle on their website. So you could do ivory, black. I don't know if they have this exact ivory belt in stock anymore, but they do have an ivory belt with the same exact gold buckle, which I recommend adding to your spring and summer belt collection because it's definitely my most worn belt in the spring and summer. And the look I want to talk about featuring these two tips, tucking in your shirt and wearing a belt, is this long white cardigan. And can I tell you, this literally feels like you're wearing a blanket. It's like you're wrapped up in a blanket. It is the softest thing I have ever put on my body. And wearing something long is also going to elongate you, making you look taller and slimmer. The key is the clothes that you put underneath the long cardigan must be slim fitting. So if I were to wear a big bulky shirt and big baggy jeans, no, wrong. This would not make me look taller and slimmer. But because my clothes are fitted underneath, I achieved that taller and slimmer look. What I paired it with is this amazing Skims bodysuit. It is like a really cool slate blue color. This bodysuit comes in six colors. It is under $100. It is so comfortable. It's probably one of my most comfortable bodysuits because it's very stretchy and it's just, you know, it does a great job of holding everything in. Of course, bodysuits are always going to stay tucked in. So that's another reason why I really love wearing bodysuits. So also they're very flattering and they're very slimming as well. Now these jeans are a bit on the baggy side. These are the Agold E 90s loose fit. I went down at least one size in these jeans, maybe two. I'll put it down in my description box, but they definitely run big. So if you're between sizes, I would say size down at least one size. This is definitely a denim silhouette that is trending really hard in 2021. I think the key of making baggier jeans look, you know, flattering and look slimming is the fact, number one, they need to be high-waisted, and number two, you need to wear a heel of some sort with the denim. What I wore with these jeans are these really cool pointy toe silver mules by Malone Solier. They're available on the Shopbop and I think the Neiman Marcus website, but I love these heels. They're fancy, they're chic, they're sophisticated, and they just add a bit of interest to any look. And because they have a pointy toe, they're also going to elongate your legs, making you look taller and slimmer. Okay, tip number seven is don't be afraid of all black. Some people think an all black look can be really harsh, which it can, but a way that you can make an all black look not look so harsh is to add a bright lip and to pair it with a nude pump. But an all black look is definitely probably one of the most slimming looks you can wear. Why? Because black is a dark color. Black is a solid color, so it's just going to make you look slimmer. It's going to make you look taller as well. So I have two looks I want to talk about with the all black tip. The first look is this amazing Veronica Beard leather blazer. It's a bit on the longer side, so it hits right below the hip, which I think is very flattering. So if you would like a blazer that kind of covers the back portion of your body, like covers your butt, basically, this would be a fabulous blazer. Again, it's a bit longer, so I did size down. I normally take a zero in Veronica Beard blazers. This one is a double zero. The leather is buttery soft. This is a very high-end blazer. It is definitely an investment, but I love the gold buttons. It's a timeless piece that will never go out of style. And then I just did the V-neck cashmere sweater underneath it. I think this sweater is on sale on the Nordstrom website. making it under $50, like what a great deal. And then I did a simple black skinny jean. A black skinny jean is a wardrobe staple every woman needs. I did a video on the 17 wardrobe staples that every woman needs in her closet, and definitely a pair of black skinnies was in that video, of course. So I will be linking those down below as well. And then I just did a black pump. Because the pumps are a pointy toe shoe, they do have an elongating effect. But this is a great classic look that could take you many places in style. Okay, all black look number two is this faux leather puff sleeve cropped jacket. This is by Blank NYC, so it's a very great price. It's either $128 or $98. I can't remember. Either way, it is such a good deal. It looks way more expensive than that. In fact, Retrofay is one of my favorite designers, and they make a jacket that literally looks identical to this one, but it's like $700. So this is just a phenomenal jacket that looks way more expensive than it really is. Then I just did a simple black bodysuit. Another way to look slimmer is to have a V neckline that is just going to elongate the top portion of your body. It's also going to allow you to wear a neck stack, which is another way to look slimmer and taller, because this décolleté area of our bodies will just elongate us if it is showing. And again, no matter what size you are, your décolleté is going to be a beautiful part of your body that you can show off. Then I did the 90s A-Gold E jeans. These are the same jeans as I had on before, but in black. Again, even though they are a baggier jean, the reason they're flattering is because, one, I sized down in them. Number two, they are very high-waisted. They have a 12-inch rise. And number three, I chose to wear a nude pointy toe pump with them, which again is another tip to make you look taller and slimmer. That brings me to tip number eight, is making sure that when you choose your shoes, you always choose a pointy toe. Of course, this doesn't mean you always have to wear pointy toe shoes, but if you're specifically trying to look slimmer and even taller, always choosing a pointy toe shoe will do just that. That is why I think probably the most flattering shoe you could wear is a classic pump. Really, more specifically, a nude pump. Are these the most comfortable shoes? No, that's why obviously we can't wear them all the time. But I did a video recently on how to make pumps more comfortable. That was one of my style hacks. One thing is, size up half a size. Number two, put a pad in the shoe, in the foot cushion area, because that's going to cushion your foot, making the pumps more comfortable. And number three, put a rubber sole pad on the bottom. You can actually take them to your local shoe repair place and they can do this. The look I want to talk about featuring this style tip is this amazing Veronica Beard black scuba blazer. This is another one of the 17 wardrobe basics. I've had this blazer for years. I wear it a ton. A black blazer is a definite wardrobe staple. This one is wrinkle-free. It's very flattering. It's very high quality. I cannot recommend the Veronica Beard scuba blazer enough. And then I just paired it over a really cool tie-dye hoodie. Even though tie-dye is a print, it's on the top portion of my body and it is made up of neutral tones, making it okay to wear this print because I didn't wear it on the bottom portion of my body and it is not a crazy loud print. Then I just did some black jeans. These are like a faded black jean with a really cool camel stitching, so it makes them a bit more unique. They're very high-waisted, more of like a modern skinny straight. And then I did the nude pointy toe pump. So I think this look is very chic. It's also very slimming and very flattering. Okay, tip number nine is to always, always, always choose high-waisted denim. Choose high-waisted denim over mid-rise denim. Choose high-waisted denim over low-rise denim. Why? Because the higher the jean, the higher the waist of the jean is on your frame, the longer it is going to make your legs look. Now, I realize depending on your height, depending on if you're long-waisted or short-waisted, will depend on which height of high-waisted denim is best for you. They have, I would say anything over a 10-inch rise is going to be considered a high rise denim. So 10 inch rise, 11 inch rise, 12 inch rise. For me, I personally, I'm 5'4" and I think I'm pretty proportional. I don't think I'm necessarily long waisted or short waisted. I think I'm just sort of medium waisted, right? So I can wear really 10, 11 or 12, but my favorite is 12. I think my legs look really long when I have a 12 inch rise. The way you can know this, honestly, every person is different. Like I said, so you're just gonna have to try them on. You can order a few, you know, deciding which rise looks best on you, that is my recommendation. But I would say always choose a jean that is at least a 10-inch rise, because again, high-waisted denim will always make you look taller and it will always make you look slimmer. The look I want to talk about with this tip is this really cool green army jacket. This is a bit on the cropped side, so I think it's very flattering. Adding a third layer is another way to look slimmer in your clothes. I also think adding a third layer is just going to elevate any look, take it to the next level. This army jacket is a wardrobe basic. I think every woman needs a really cool army jacket in her closet. I know I wear mine a ton. This one is under $100, so it's very reasonably priced, and I really love this dark olive green color. I paired it over an all black look, just a black bodysuit and my black redone jeans. As you can see, there's a lot of repeated bodysuits and jeans in this video, because if your wardrobe is made up of basics, like a black bodysuit, like a pair of black jeans, like a white button down, like a white t-shirt, you know, you're going to be able to get dressed very easily every day. And all of these basics can sort of be mixed and matched and worn together to create different looks by just adding a different jacket like I did here. So that's a really good tip. And again, if you're looking for basics and which ones you need in your closet to complete your wardrobe basic checklist, I did that video and I will link it down below. But love this look. I also followed the rule. I tucked the shirt in, I added a belt, and I have on the pointy toe leopard pumps. Okay, tip number 10, and probably the most important tip, is to know your body type. So really knowing your body type, following the ABC rule, accentuate, balance, and camouflage. You know, what is your best feature? Whatever that is for you, accentuate it. If that is your waist, then yes, tucking your shirt in all the way, wearing the high-waisted denim. If that is your legs, then maybe you like to wear dresses and skirts more. If you're very, you know, if your shoulders are really broad, then maybe you don't wear jackets with big shoulder pads. Like, you've really got to know your body type, and you've really got to know which items on your body to accentuate, which ones you need to camouflage, and then you just balance it all out. That is important, because that will definitely make you look taller and also make you look slimmer. So I hope that you ladies enjoyed this video. I hope it was helpful. Please let me know what your favorite tip was down below by just leaving me a comment, because like I said, I always love hearing from y'all. For more style information, you can head over to soheather.com, and on Instagram, I'm soheatherblog. I hope you guys have a beautiful day, and until next time, I will see you soon. Bye-bye.